Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. In this video, we will discuss Chapter 2, Class 12 Mathematics, Inverse Trigonometric Function. In that, cosec inverse function. First, let us see the domain and range of cosec trigonometric function. For the cosec function, the domain is r minus x such that x is equal to n pi, n belongs to z, and the range is r minus open interval minus 1 comma 1. See here, from the set of real number, we have to exclude all these values. The reason is, whenever we consider the cosec function, we can write that as 1 by sin x. And we know that the sin x is 0 at these values, 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, at these values the sin x is equal to 0. So 1 by 0 means that gives infinity, which is undefined. So that is the reason that from the set of real number we have to exclude all these values, as we are writing the cosec as 1 by sin x. So here n pi is given and n belongs to the set of integers. So that here if it is 0, we have sin 0, if it is 1, pi, if it is 2, 2 pi, if it is 3, 3 pi, like this way we get all these values, and these values we are excluding from the domain. Next, the range is r minus open interval minus 1 to 1. Here minus 1 as well as 1 is included. All the values in between this needs to be excluded. Those values we can't consider, the values in between minus 1 and 1. So that is about the domain and range of cosec function. Now here see, I have taken the table of the cosec function. Based on this, we can plot the graph of the cosec function. This is the table which has values starting from 0 to 360 degree. So let us plot the graph here. See, we have the x-axis and y-axis. For 0 degree, the value is infinity. Then for 90 degree, the value is 1. Then for 180 degree, the value is again infinity. So these dotted line represent the infinity values. So here also you can have a dotted line. The 0 means it is infinity. Then for 360 degree, infinity. Similarly, on the left hand side, for minus pi, infinity. For minus 2 pi, infinity. So that is the value of the cosec function. Based on this, we can plot the graph. See, we can have the graph like this way. You can observe here, that is from for the interval 0 to pi. Here, the value we have like this way, 2 square root of 2, then 2 square root of 3, 2 divided by square root of 3, then 1, then again the same values are repeated. That means we get the graph like this way. So here we can have the graph of the cosec function. Next step is, see here, in this case we are interested in cosec inverse function, and we know that from the first chapter the inverse of the function exists only if the function is invertible. Invertible means the function must be bijective, and to call any function as bijective it must be 1 1 and onto. So now let us see whether the cosec function is 1 1 or not, so that we can find the inverse. See here, in this case, suppose if I take these set of values, you can clearly observe that here for cosec 30 degree answer is 2, for cosec 150 degree also answer is 2. Or if I represent this in the form of mapping diagram with some values, so you can clearly observe here for every image in the codomain we have 2 pre-images or more than 2 pre-images. That shows that this cosec function is not 1-1. To form 1-1, every image must have a unique pre-image. These values are known as pre-images and these values are known as images. In this case, if I increase this value, the degree values, negative side as well as positive side, then for each value we may have 2 pre-images or more than 2 pre-images. That shows that this cosec function is not 1-1. That means we can't find the inverse. Then how to find the inverse? So now to find the inverse, we have to make this cosec function as inverse 1-1. So to make the cosec function as 1-1, instead of taking all the set of values, we have to consider here part of the graph. That is, instead of taking the complete graph, we have to consider only small part of the graph where the cosec function is 1, 1. Let us check that at which part the cosec function is 1, 1. See, now here, if I take this interval, is it 1, 1? That is 0 to pi? No, right? You can observe that clearly. Anyway, for 0 and 180 degree, it is not defined. So we can't consider that value. But in between 0 to pi, see here, for 30 degree also it gives 2. For 150 degree also it gives 2. That means for one image 2, we have 2 preimages at this interval. That shows that it is not 1, 1. So you can't take this interval. Then which interval we can take? Let us take the interval like this way. Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. See, at this interval, see here, the values are going to the negative side, whereas here the values are going to the positive side. That means that indicates that definitely the function is 1, 1. For every image, we have a unique pre-image in this case, as this line gives the positive value, whereas this side gives the negative value. Here you can't consider the 0, and because for 0 degree it is infinity, by excluding the 0 at this interval, you can see that the cosec function is 1, 1. Similarly, here pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. If I take this interval by excluding this pi, as for cosec pi it is infinity, you can see here the positive value, here it represents the negative value. So every image has a unique pre-image, so at this interval also it is 1, 1. Similarly, we can have the interval like this way, here and here. At this interval also it is 1, 1. Here also you have to exclude minus pi, as it gives the infinity value. So now here, instead of taking the whole set of graph, we have divided the graph into smaller intervals like this way. That is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 minus 0, minus 3 pi by 2 to minus pi by 2 minus pi, minus minus pi. Then we have this interval, and at this interval we have seen that the cosec function is 1, 1. Then what about the range? If you consider the each interval, the range is not going to change. Here we have 1, here we have minus 1, and then we have all the set of values. Whereas the values in between minus 1 to 1 are not included. So here also see, these values are not included. That means definitely the range is same. The range is not going to change. We have to just make the restriction on the domain. So we have now these intervals, and we come to know that at these interval the cosec function is 1, 1. So now here you can redefine a cosec function by taking any one of these interval. Here this interval is known as a default interval. This is the standard interval which we follow while solving all the cosec inverse function problems. So let us take that. See, now we have to consider the new cosec function with the domain closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 minus 0. Closed interval means here minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. These values are also included, plus the values in between this are included. Minus 0 means, see, for cosec 0 we get the answer infinity. So that we can't consider. So that we have to remove from this interval. So here we have this domain. Next, the range is same, R minus open interval minus 1 comma 1. This is the open interval. That means here minus 1 comma 1 are not included, so that comes under this, that is under range. The remaining values which are there in between this, that we have to exclude from this range. Now let us consider the cosec inverse function. When we write the cosec inverse function, we have to just interchange the domain and the range. So here we have this as the range that you have to make as domain, R minus minus 1 comma 1. This we have a domain that you have to make as a range for the cosec inverse. So we got here cosec inverse as well as cosec. Next here, let us draw the graph. See, for the cosec, we have taken the interval like this way. That is starting from here to here and then here to here. So we have to draw the graph for that. See, here we can have the graph like this way. That is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So you can have the graph like this way, where you have to exclude this 0. For cosec 0, it is infinity. Next here, based on this graph, you can have the cosec inverse graph. While drawing the cosec inverse graph, you have to interchange the x and y axis. So on the x axis, you have to write the real number values. That is this one that forms the domain, and on the y-axis you have to write the radian values, that is this forms the range for the cosec inverse. Based on that, you can have the graph like this way. So this is the graph of the cosec inverse x at this interval. Now, as we have taken here this interval to represent the cosec inverse function, we call the interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 minus 0 as principal value branch. See, here we get many intervals and at all these intervals the cosec function is 1, 1. You can take any interval, but when this cosec inverse function is defined, that time they have taken one interval as the standard interval. So that's why now I am taking this interval. So this is about cosec inverse function. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. Thanks for watching.